I'm Anne Skeldon. I'm a professor in the Department of Mathematics at Surrey. I'm very interested in using mathematics to help understand the world around me. Over the last 10 years, that has primarily been about understanding the daily rhythms in humans, primarily those of sleep and wake and the body clock. Messing up our daily rhythms can have serious health consequences, including type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and some forms of cancer. More generally, if we are well rested and in tune with our body clock, we feel and perform better. So I've been working in close collaboration with Dirk-Jan Dyke at the Surrey Sleep Research Centre. For me, it's been a fascinating interdisciplinary journey using mathematics to help understand how biology, the environment, and our daily rhythms interact. As an example, it is sometimes said that biological changes during adolescence make it hard for teenagers to get up in time for school. This means that teenagers end up sleep deprived. When people are sleep deprived, they're grumpier, they make poorer decisions, and it's harder for them to learn or to remember. One proposed solution has been that we should start school later for adolescents. It's not just our biology, but it's also our interaction with light and our environment that determines when we want to sleep. For teenagers and young adults, the key is to get enough light early in the day and turn down the lights in the evening. Mathematics helps us to understand the interaction between how much light we get, the resulting preferred sleep timing, and whether or not it will help to change school start times. Our work has been used in debates on moving school start times, both in the UK and in the USA. Going forward, there are two major areas that we're focusing on right now. The first is about designing personalised light interventions to improve sleep for those living with dementia and also for some mental health disorders. A second major area for us is looking at mathematical models of fatigue. When people are sleep deprived, they make more mistakes. Mathematical models are one part of a range of measures to help manage work schedules. We are working to make models more accurate and better account for individual differences. For example, not everyone needs the same amount of sleep. In many ways, sleep research is an ideal area for interdisciplinary research. Using mathematics, we are having a real impact on how biology, the society, and the environment interact. But at the same time, the biology is leading us to tackle some new mathematical questions.